Wah bam bloom bam 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 to the food.
Morning Drive with Mike Bagley and Pete Pistone.
Oh, Rudy. Oh, bum, 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 bum. I got a girl named Sue.
8 minutes before the top of the hour. Back on the Morning Drive, Adam Stern, Sports Business Daily, Sports Business Journal. Coming up later in the show, Ricky Stenhouse Jr. will join us, 10:30 a.m. Eastern Time. Hey, Pete?
Yes?
What is today?
Today, Bagman, is Thursday, April 20th, 2023.
Making it 420 day today.
Oh, I thought we were going to hear Son of a Preacher Man.
Well, Cypress Hill, Petey.
Okay, sorry.
In a similar and related celebration, today is National Munchies Day.
Sometimes I smoke pot, and I'll go I went to a Burger King. I went to the Burger King sometimes to eat there because I don't care about my body.
What is the top munchie food? But post 420 or not? Just in general, is there one like a go to? Anything you can get your hands on, basically.
Bag of chips. It has to be like a bag of chips.
Anything that's crunchy.
Crunchy and salty, I would say, for me, that would be a munchie. Yeah.
Well, there's another celebration that could or cannot be directly tied into the events of the day. Today is National Cheddar Fries Day.
Okay. That fits the bill. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah.
That could answer your question. Yeah.
Best cheddar fries that we have in Chicago at the Wiener Circle, the hot dog place in the city that's a little salty in terms of when they take your order and such. They put that cheese, you know, that cheese that we have up there at the Mars Cheese Castle that's on the bar that you spread on the crackers.
Yeah.
They put that on top of the French fries and melt it. Boys.
Son. Today is also Get to Know Your Customers Day.
I have people skills. I am good at dealing with people. Can't you understand that? What the hell is wrong with you people?
That's Sammy answering the phone, isn't it?
Well, depends on who it is.
I wish I could play the first part of that because he's even more impassioned about how he helps the engineers not deal with the customers. It's just a great rant.
I need to watch that movie. Best. I got to watch Office Space. I'm ready for that again.
I'm kind of torn here with the state of affairs as far as customers and people that you get goods and services from.
Mm-hmm.
The quality's taken a hit and the prices have gone up. You get less, but the attitude seems to be more in play from some folks than it used to be. And it's like, I'm not the one that's pissing you off. I hated that, you know, two people ago tore you up, but don't take it out on me. And especially that you're charging me more and giving me less. Come on now.
Now, a question. Did you drop any popcorn on the plane yesterday and did they make you pick it up?
No, I did not.
I could see Mike stuffing a pillow under his shirt. I'm 22 weeks pregnant.
I came in and I found this on the ground. Look at this in the camera, boys.
Popcorn?
Yes. It's all a kernel. Right. A pop kernel.
Yeah. Jackson's going to get on
the Anthony Bass to drive out on MLB there this week. All right, we press on. On this day in 1534, Jacques Cartier, a French explorer, set sail from St. Malo to explore the North American coastline.
You can set your watch by that Cartier.
On this day, 1653, in England, Oliver Cromwell expelled the Long Parliament for trying to pass the perpetuation bill that would have kept Parliament in the hands of only a few members.
Hmm. Got shot down on that one, did he? Sounds like.
Done. Get out. On this day in 1832, Hot Springs National Park was initially created by an act of Congress. It was the first time a piece of land was set aside by the U.S. government to preserve the area for recreation. The area was made a national park on March 4th, 1921.
Feeling hot, hot, hot.
It's also the last time an act of Congress actually did anything. I remember, if I remember.
Feeling hot, hot, hot.
Woo! On this day in 1837, Erastus B. Bigelow was granted a patent for his power loom.
Old Erastus.
It sounds like a wrestling move. Well, hit him with the old power loot, baby.
I know,
he's
right?
not getting coming up from that.
And
one.
Here comes Bigelow.
Here he comes. Here comes Bigelow from the top turnbuckle.
Get in there.
On this day in 1865, safety matches were first advertised.
Safety first for lighten up.
On this day in 1879, the first mobile home, horse-drawn mobile home, was used in a journey from London to Cyprus.
Those poor horses.
Hold it up, boys.
Those
Here
poor
we go.
Horses. My God. What do you got in there? It's a long run.
Yeah.
Man. On this day in 1912, Fenway Park opened as the home of the Boston Red Sox.
Never been. Got to get there. Got to go.
It's pretty cool. Been there one time. On this day in 1916, Sir Roger Casement landed in Ireland to incite rebellion against the British. Casement, a British diplomat, was captured within hours and was hanged for high treason on August 3rd.
Boy, that escalated quickly. I mean, that really got out of hand fast.
They don't take treason lightly over there, apparently. Jeez.
On this day in 1959, Desilu Playhouse on CBS TV presented a two-part show titled The Untouchables.
Ah, Desilu, of course, Desi Arnaz and Lucy.
Mm-hmm. On this day in 1961, FM stereo broadcasting was approved by the FCC. But they said it really loud. They said it
on the air, on the video. In stereo.
On this day in 1972, the manned lunar module from Apollo 16 landed on the moon.
We landed on the moon!
See? There you go.
And on this day in 1982, the Activision game Pitfall was released for the Atari 2600 game system.
30. Nice system.
Birthdays today. Luther Vandross would have been 72. Yes, the theme song for Talladega this weekend. Can't be with the one you love, love the one you with. Shamar Moore, 53. Jessica Lange, 74. Carmen Electra, 51. Joey Lawrence, 47. George Takei, 86. In the world of NASCAR, birthdays for Adrian Fernandez, Ron Barfield, and Frankie Stoddard.
Well, happy birthday, one and all, on this Thursday, April 20th, 2023.